Welcome. My name is Colin Murphy, Product Marketing Manager at Microsoft. I'm joined today by Rohit,
Hey.
Program Manager
in
the Data Platform team, correct?
Yes, I'm a Program Manager and I mainly look at connectivity for SQL database.
Okay, oh, cool. And then you're going to show us a demo today on like how to set up network rules for Azure SQL database, correct?
Absolutely. So we'll start with the scenario that we left off with last time, which is the fact that let's assume you have a virtual machine and you have a SQL database and you want to connect the two.
Okay.
So let's switch desktop and I'll take you through the process of how you do that.
Okay.
So out on my Azure portal here, this is my virtual machine that's running. And this is my SQL database server. And when I go under firewall settings, what I've done is I've whitelisted the IP address of the virtual machine here. Now with this, when I log into the virtual machine and try to connect via Management Studio, my connection goes in fine. And I can confirm that I'm indeed connecting from that IP address by just running this query. Okay, wrong database. And you can see I'm coming from the IP address of the VM. So till now, nothing magical has happened,
okay.
Right? I mean, this is very routine scenario. But what I'm going to show you next is how you can kind of restrict this scenario even further. And there are good reasons why people may not want to just do this in production, because you're just opening up the IP address. So there are additional measures that IT administrators can put on the networking side of the virtual machine. And these are done at the network security group level by adding what is called as an outbound rule. So when we add an outbound rule, essentially what we do is we restrict where the outgoing traffic from the virtual machine can communicate to.
Gotcha, okay.
And this again gives the IT security people or the network security people additional controls they can put on the virtual machine so that you're not open communicating to anywhere in the world.
Right, yeah, so for real world applications, this is typically what IT would do. They would actually control the firewalls,
absolutely,
the network security of a mission critical application. So this is their domain where they would actually be setting these things up.
Yes, because now I'm working with a plain vanilla VM, so we have outbound internet connectivity,
mm-hmm.
but in real world scenarios, that is not a privilege that you have everywhere. So let me show you how we do that. We say our source address is an IP address, and the IP address is basically this IP address, which is the public IP of the virtual machine. Source port ranges, I want to open up port 1433 and port range 11,000 through 11,999. So remember port 14. Yes. So basically what we are saying is from the virtual machine IP address, we will communicate to 1433, which is for our gateway machine. And that will redirect us to a port between 11,000 and 11,999, which is where our SQL database will reside.
Mm-hmm.
So this is on the source side. So now on the destination side, what we can do is use a concept called service tag. And this basically says, since my database is in West US, I'll say SQL.WestUS. So what that does is allow me outbound to any SQL database in the West US region.
Mm-hmm.
And then this can be star. Our protocol is we want to communicate via TCP, we want allow. We'll set it at a low enough priority so that it takes precedence over other rules. And say allow SQL should be good enough. And we say add. So all I'm doing here is I'm building an enhancement on the previous scenario that I showed you. In the sense, nothing has changed here. I'm still able to connect, but now I can do more granular things at the network security group level. So I could basically deny access to certain regions or only allow specific ports, things like that.
Okay.
So this is one example of how the network security component of Azure networking can come into play when connecting to SQL database.
Okay, so through this network security group, through this role here, I've allowed SQL, anyone in that region to connect to that SQL database.
That's correct.
Okay, but that's in my subscription. So it's not the world, it's not the internet, it's correct. just within my Azure subscription.
It's actually very more specific than that. It's only from the source IP address of the VM
okay.
to any SQL database in West US.
Gotcha.
Right. So that was our first demo.
Mm-hmm.
And now I'm going to switch out, do a little bit of setup here. So get rid of this.
And this is typically definitely what IT pros would use for setting up their firewalls for their apps. So it's,
yes.
And then do they have to do this? Is this something that is, we tell people they have to go do this for when they're deploying SQL in Azure?
No, this is one way of securing
mm-hmm.
access. I mean, you can do it at multiple levels. People do it at network security group is something that's a concept at the VM level.
Mm-hmm.
But there are other layers of networking, like you can have what is called as a network virtual appliance, which basically does packet inspections for anything flowing inside your network.
Mm-hmm.
You can also define custom routing rules that allow or deny routing of packets between certain parts, which are your subnets within your virtual network. So what I've shown you is just one level of network security, which is at the VM level. And this can be scaled up or down at different levels within the network stack.
Great. So we've offered lots of tiering of security here and lots of options for
absolutely.
Security.
Absolutely. Yeah,
as well.
We are just scratching the surface in terms of what we allow on the network security side. Okay, so great. So now what I'm going to do is basically disconnect here. Now let's go on to our next demo, and this is more relevant to what we can do from the SQL database side. So I'm in my firewall settings here, and note that there is nothing in the IP firewall. So this mm-hmm. is blank. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to add what is called as a virtual network firewall rule. And remember what it does is we start using the private IP address of the VM to communicate with and not the public IP address. Now for that, we need to do a slight tweak at the VM level. So which is...
We'd never want to use the public IP address, correct?
Correct, yes. That would be the
preferred... opening up our database to the world.
Absolutely.
Or potentially.
Yeah, and a lot of scenarios, customers don't have a public IP address for their VMs. So that's a very good security conscious. Customers will not even allow this. So all this becomes all the more important. So here you see I have a private IP address sending in .4, which comes from this VM subnet 2. So I'm going to click on that, go find my VM subnet here. So bear with me while I click through. And here's a very interesting thing that I'm going to do now, which is there's a feature called service endpoints. And I'm going to click and say Microsoft.SQL. And let's read the text that comes here. It basically says with service endpoints, the IP address will switch from using public IPv4 to private IPv4. So that's the key thing to note here is once we enable
mm-hmm.
a service endpoint for Microsoft.SQL, on the subnet, then that subnet immediately switches from public to private IP addresses. So at this point...
And that's everything on that subnet?
Yes.
Gotcha.
So
you have to be careful planning this to
absolutely.
Make sure some of your, if you've got other services, things running on that subnet, that
yes.
they don't rely on the public IP.
Yes. So that's why usually it's a good idea to, you'll see I've segmented my subnets here. So usually it's a good idea to keep a subnet only for a specific purpose. So I have a subnet for VMs, have a subnet for my apps, and so on.
Yep.
So once I do this, and this is where probably we'll have to pause the demo a bit, because this takes a little bit of time to update here, because it's actually switching the subnet traffic from public to private. So let's wait for this to get done.
Great, so that just takes a couple of minutes to do that?
Yes, so now we have switched the subnet traffic over to using private IP. Let me just go back here and show you what happens when I try to connect. Let me go ahead and reset this. And I'll get this very specific error message. It says cannot open server requested by login. So this error message indicates that I'm trying to connect via the private IP address, but I'm not there yet because I can't resolve it, right? I'm trying from the virtual machine side, but my traffic is not going out. So we'll now go and kind of put the plumbing in for that traffic to go out. And that we do on the, again, on the SQL server side. So we go under firewall settings. And again, note that we are not adding anything in the IP address space. Rather, we are clicking on this section at the bottom, which says virtual networks. And we're going to add a new, can take the default name, that's fine. Pick my subscription. Now here you need to be careful to pick the correct subnet. So remember,
this is the subnet now that's just going to accept in private traffic only.
Exactly.
Okay.
And you see that it has a service endpoint that's enabled. So that's the prerequisite for it to start accepting traffic.
Okay. So if you selected one that didn't have a service endpoint, that's probably your red flag to know that it's not going to work.
Yeah. Or you'll more than likely run into an error message that tells you that you need to enable this feature. So now I click OK here, and it's basically going to update a metadata on the SQL database side. So you'll see a new rule pop up here in a minute or less than that. Okay, so now you see that we have a new VNet firewall rule that is basically allowing us access to this VM subnet 2. And it says the state is ready. So now we'll see that the address will have been switched to using the private IP address. So let me just run this again, this DMV query. And you can see this is now listing the client address as 10.1.0.4, which is the IP address, private IP address of the VM. So this is how, by using VNet firewall rules, we have basically switched from using the public IP address, taken that out of the picture altogether.
Completely, yeah.
And we are using the private IP address. And this is a feature that we want more and more customers to know about and start using.
Okay.
And again, we are putting more investments in this area. So we are taking this story further. And so you'll see more announcements in the future in this area. But for now, what this gives you is, if you have virtual machines in a subnet, then you can restrict access from that subnet to SQL database using VNet firewall rules.
Cool, that's really great.
So that was our demo.
Thank you very much. So thank you everyone for tuning in on how to set up some network firewall rules for Azure SQL database. Give us a like and we will see you next time. Thank you.
Thank you.